Today's vlog is all about playing synth bass on the bass guitar. Don't get me wrong, for my money, playing synth bass is best played on a synthesizer, on some sort of keyboard. I've played everything from the Nord Lead rack with a controller keyboard to Moogs to Voyager, you name it. I've played a bunch of keyboards to get synth bass. I think that is by far and away the best way to do it, especially when playing like R&B or pop. For me, there's just a feel about that that is awesome. Sonically, it makes sense. There are just so many things about playing those lines on a keyboard that make sense. But playing synth bass on a bass guitar is an unbelievable amount of fun, and it's really actually quite simple to do. You don't need a ton of pedals, you don't need to spend a ton of money. I'm gonna give you a bunch of different signal chain options, a bunch of things I've used on the road over the years, and they kind of range from the fairly reasonable in terms of cost to the completely insane and actually kind of hard to find because some of these pedals aren't made anymore. So hopefully there's a range in there that kind of suits everyone, and you can see where my head is at in terms of creating synth bass sounds for the bass guitar. I would highly recommend checking out people like Tim LaFave and especially John Davis, especially his work with Jojo Mayer's band Nerve. He's kind of building modular synths with pedals essentially and playing them with the bass guitar, and I think it's unbelievable. It's an awesome sound. Definitely check that out. But in my little world of synth bass, having learned stuff from Jojo, from John, from Tim LaFave, from all of those guys, and then kind of thrown in my own ideas, these are the kinds of things I've come up with. The first one, and I'm gonna leave the compressor on for all of these. I have an old CS2. So already the first pedal I mentioned, they don't make anymore. It's kind of tough to find, and it's not cheap when you buy it. It just happens to be the compressor I like to use for the most part when I'm kind of making these older, vintagey sounds. So I have the CS2 up front. I'm gonna leave that on with the same setting throughout this entire explanation and demo of all these synth bass options. First in the chain after the compressor is my OC2. I have a Boss OC2 Octaver. Again, second pedal I talk about, they don't make it anymore. There are some great alternatives on the market, and I happen to have them all here, and I can show them to you. Of course, the Aguilar, the Optimizer, great octave pedal, the MXR Bass Octave Deluxe. I know Mike League uses this one. I've seen some videos of him using it, and he makes this sound amazing. I'm not quite sure what his setup and his signal chain is, but obviously an amazing pedal by MXR, Bass Octave Deluxe, great option. I'm using the original, the Japanese Octaver with the R on the end, the oldest one, the toughest one to get. You can get the Taiwanese OC2s a little bit later and made in Taiwan, but you can get them a little bit easier and a little bit cheaper online. They do a great job. You can use the same Jojo Mayer setting. I have all of these set to all of my OC2s, regardless of where they were made. I have them all set to that. Totally an option to use this one. And I have from Three Leaf Audio, the Octave. It's basically taking Tim LaFave's last name and putting the word octave in there. And Tim worked with these guys at Three Leaf Audio. This thing sounds awesome. Really, really great pedal. Probably the closest thing to the original OC2 I've ever heard. And then plus some other options as well, like some sub stuff in there. So those are all amazing options. They're gonna work in a very similar manner. Slight differences, of course, but they are gonna work in a similar manner in terms of where my octave pedal is in the signal chain. And we'll get to this a little bit later, but don't sleep on the DOD Meatbox, the reissue. I just got this. I did a full review of this. You can check that out in the link below in the description of this video. That's more of a subharmonic pedal. That's not an octave pedal. So we'll get to that later. That definitely appears on my radar when it comes to synth bass and low end and that kind of stuff. So let's get to a pedal you can actually buy that's in my signal chain. It is the Exotic Bass BB preamp. Now this is where my kind of distortion is coming from. Although it's a preamp, what I'm doing is I'm smashing the gain to 100%, and then I'm pulling in the volume until the signal starts to break up. That is where you're getting this. That's where the fuzzy synth element is coming from when you hear that in the sound. Now, also another side note is the EQ in any of these pedals, like the BB preamp, the bass BB preamp from Exotic. I have the treble kind of smashed as well. I have the treble all the way maxed out, and I kind of have the bass in the middle. I'm getting plenty of bass from my OC2 and from the bass itself. I don't need to smash the bass that much on the preamp. But the treble really helps bring those highs and bring that synth element to the whole sound. It's a pretty evil sounding synth option. Now, what I will say is I'm not gonna go too heavily into modulation on this video. I'm gonna throw a couple of little options in, but modulation is a whole other thing. We're talking about delays, we're talking about envelope filters, we're talking about tremolos, we're talking about all that kind of stuff that modulates the sound. That adds a whole other dimension to it. This video could be 5 hours long if we did synth and modulation. So I'm gonna sprinkle it in, but I'm not gonna get too heavy into the modulation thing, but bear in mind that does bring a whole other dynamic to your synth sound, and it's something that I think is very important. And I will give you a quick rundown at the end of the video of all the kind of modulating pedals that I use, and a brief thing about kind of how I use them and what they do. So that's the first setup. Second setup, we're gonna switch out the bass BB preamp, switch that off. I'm gonna leave the compressor and the OC2 in where they are, and I'm gonna bring in the Woolly Mammoth by Zivex. An unbelievable pedal. They do still make this. It is not the cheapest option by far. I think this one is over $300. It might be closer to $400. It's a distortion pedal. I'm using it in a very similar way to the BB preamp, where I'm kind of driving it. It's a little more evil sounding. It's definitely more aggressive to me. I know that, and I really have to be careful. You know, the output right now, I haven't touched the compressor or the OC2, and the output is way down on the Woolly Mammoth. It's an incredibly powerful pedal. I believe John Davis still uses one. If he doesn't, he did do for a long time, so I'm sure a lot of the Nerve sounds you can hear on record involve a Woolly Mammoth. It's really a staple of this kind of sound. You know, and I just barely moved the output knob a hair there, and it really took off in volume and power. Again, I have the EQ kind of on the trebly end, and it's output, EQ, pinch, and wool. Those are the four options on this pedal. Oh yeah. Big sounding pedal. Quick side note, I opted to use my P bass, which is a passive bass obviously, with flat wound strings. For my money, the pedals, and when I'm doing all this synth bass and kind of low end manipulation stuff, they respond better to a passive bass. I do obviously use my Federa when I'm playing live and when I'm doing the looping thing and the solo world tour and all that kind of stuff, but I don't actually play a lot of synth bass then. So when it comes to playing kind of electronic music and this kind of sound, this kind of setup, I much prefer the flat wound strings and the passive electronics of a P bass. Okay, gonna give you a third option for distortion in terms of building that basic synth bass setup. And the reason I like it, look how small this guy is. This is by Maleco Heavy Industries. This is their fuzz pedal. It's tiny, it's simple, two knobs, one button. It does have a selector switch inside where you can select, I think, a double octave. I think I have everything maxed out in there. But I wanted to show you this pedal first of all and give you an idea of what it sounds like. I like it for a multitude of reasons. It's powerful. Big time. And who doesn't like more real estate on their pedal board? I love it. It takes up no space at all. And for that, it gets a massive two thumbs up for me in terms of not just sound and ability and options, but of course, the all important real estate in the pedal board. And it's pretty powerful. Currently driving my neighbors absolutely mental with this. Gonna get moving before it gets too late and before we get shut down, before I get to the end of this synth bass exploration. And let's throw in one tiny piece of modulation advice. I put a delay on the end of the signal chain now and just have a dotted eighth note dialed up in terms of the delay. So I'm playing really very little with the right hand. I'm playing very few notes on the bass, but the delay gives it that kind of space, gives it that electronic vibe to a certain extent, and plays that dotted quarter note. I'm tapping the tempo at the same time. easy to stay in tempo while I'm playing on my own because I can hear everything so much. But when you get into a band situation and things are kind of taking off and there's a thousand different things going on around you, it's nice to have that tap tempo just to keep locked in with the rest of the band. We've kind of run through three distortion options and a modulation option right now. What I didn't talk about was the fact that how huge the OC2 is on its own and how kind of sine wavy and electronic sounding it is, and how I could probably get away with doing most electronic music gigs with just that pedal. It's such a great... It is such a great sound just on its own. It's fat, you know, that's with the compressor on. If I took the compressor off, a little thinner because I have the compressor kind of jamming, but you know, what a great sound just on its own. So even without spending a ton of money or having 5, 6, 7 pedals in your pedal board, you can do a lot with just that OC2. And I had the delay on there a little bit, so an OC2 and a delay, great setup. I should say that two things that are missing from my pedal library, from my collection, the Akai Deep Impact. I do wish I had that pedal. Costs an absolute fortune. I think it's up to almost $1,000 the last time I saw one on Reverb or eBay or something. That's definitely on the wish list. It is an amazing pedal for synth bass, big time. Really, really want to get that. Big bucket list pedal right there. And of course, the Mutron, the envelope filter, which kind of helps out with those whizz, whizz kind of sounds once you put the distortions in there and some synth, all kinds of stuff. Those two, the Deep Impact and the Mutron, definitely on my bucket list of pedals that I need to buy, but they both cost an absolute fortune. So it's kind of, should I get a car? Should I get two pedals? It's kind of one of those things. So don't think I'm unaware of those pedals. I love those pedals to bits. Love to play them when I get a chance. Just don't happen to have them in my library right now. So anybody who knows me and knows my playing a little bit or has ever heard me play with pedals knows I love bit crushers. Bit crushers for me can also play the same role, you know, when it comes to creating synth bass and kind of funky sounds like that. They can also play the same role that the distortion has been playing up until now. I have two in the pedal board right now to make an example. One is the Iron Ether Frantabit, and the other is the Bug Brand Bit Crusher. That's a company from the UK. I'm pretty sure they don't make that pedal anymore, unfortunately. I found it online, or I found it through a contact who sold it to me or something. It might even have been a home kit pedal that they'd built themselves, you know, from Bug Brand in the UK. I don't remember exactly the story behind it. But if I get rid of the delay, and you can hear kind of where the bug element, the Bug Brand, kind of sounds a little bit like a bug. And it's a versatile pedal. I just plugged it in and switched it on right now. If I just hold this D here, we can do a lot of damage. It's a really fun pedal. There are so many things you can do with it. Percussive things when you're looping, obviously bassline stuff like that, and kind of modulating and manipulating the OC2. I love that pedal big time. Okay, the Iron Ether Frantabit. That's the second bit crusher I have here to show you guys. It has a switch on it that says degrade and obliterate. Those are your only two options for the pedal. Degrade or obliterate. Those are the two modes. Obviously it has, you know, one, two, it has five knobs to manipulate all kinds of different parameters, but the two modes of the pedal are degrade and obliterate. We're in degrade mode. This is the lesser of the two modes right now. And it doesn't disappoint. I love this pedal. If I put the delay, oh. Pretty badass, like how the note changes over time. really great pedal. And again, another nice, tasty synth option. So it's not just distortions and overdriven preamps that you can use to create that distorted sound. I love bit crushers as well. I kind of had to throw this pedal in there, the Boss SYB3, the bass synthesizer, because it, you know, it's a bass synthesizer. It seems like a logical option. Have the OC2 going through it, the same signal chain, compressor, OC2, and now the bass synth. But it doesn't track very well. And it's a little glitchy. And not the greatest sounding pedal. And for my money, I like, if I'm gonna go for a sound like that, I much prefer having like the Woolly Mammoth and the OC2 than a pedal that's kind of glitchy like the SYB3. All right, the next option, and one of the last options I'm giving you guys here in terms of synth bass, is a slightly more expensive one. This is the Freq Box, the Mooga Fooga Freq Box. It can be kind of a glitchy pedal, but when you get it right and you get it in that sweet spot, it does have an amazing amount of potential. It's not something I've used terribly successfully live, but at home or in the studio, it's been pretty cool. I mean, it really does have some funky sounds. You can change the waveform from triangle to square. Multiple kinds of triangle. To another kind of square. There's just so many parameters to it. Pretty evil sound. I keep coming up with this word, evil. It is pretty evil sounding. It's a great option. I do use an expression pedal with it for the mix and all kinds of stuff like that. But like I said, it's a little complicated, a little glitchy, but it does have some amazing options when you really dial it in. Let's also give a quick mention to some other distortion options. I have used all of these in some sort of live or studio recording situation before. They're all awesome pedals. You know, that's the, when you have 15 distortion pedals and you have to pick one, it's virtually impossible. I switch out between, you know, I have like a top three or four that I use, but it is really tough. And these are some other options that you might want to check out. Wren and Cuff make the Pickle Pie Hella Fuzz. And the knob is missing there. I need maintenance on my pedals so badly. Juan Alderetti turned me on to these guys. They were kind enough to send me one. It is an awesome pedal. I love the blend knob on the side because I can reach down with my toe and kind of blend that back and forth with my toe while I'm playing. Great live performance option. Right there. The MXR, the bass overdrive, super solid overdrive pedal. You can get those synth bass effects with that pedal. TC Electronic have three pedals that I've used. The Mojo overdrive, Mojo, 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 or just Mojo, Mojo. Yeah, Mojo, Mojo. The overdrive, the Dark Matter. Also, bear in mind, these are all guitar pedals, by the way. These are not bass pedals, these three TC Electronic pedals. They're all guitar pedals, but I have made them sound great with the bass and the OC2. And gotta love it just for the name, is the Rottweiler distortion. Love those pedals. These three, despite the fact that they are guitar pedals, have worked great for synth bass sounds on the bass. And last two options for synth bass options when it comes to distortion and fuzz, the Aguilar Fuzzista and the Aguilar Agro. Very, very cool pedals. I've used them a bunch. I actually like these pedals more for just straight up distortion or fuzz, not in the context of synth bass. I think these are amazingly well-made pedals and great sounding pedals. Really like them in terms of just playing rock, playing with a pick, playing with a P-bass, that kind of sound. But they are options and they will do a good job when it comes to creating synth bass sounds. And what was I thinking? I couldn't finish talking about distortion without including Sovtek Big Muffs, original ones, Russian made, the real deal. Yes, I have two. Yes, they are stupidly expensive. These are not options for everyone. And I think I just got scared that I wasn't gonna be able to find more than one and I wanted a backup. So I ended up spending the time, saving up the money, getting two of those bad boys. They are insane. I mean, they're not the most versatile thing in the world, but they are insane, sonically speaking. And last but not least, I love this. Look, it's all clunking around and it's falling apart, probably. I don't know. It's a big chunky old pedal. It's beat to hell, but it's the Maestro Fuzz. It is another awesome option for synth bass. I really dig it. It's just a little cumbersome to be taken on the road. That's definitely a home or studio pedal. So let's finish up with two things. Obviously, playing synth bass and playing sub bass and all that kind of stuff, you can't really not talk about the Meatbox, the DOD Meatbox. I have the new reissue model. It works great. It is, as I said before in my full review, the only pedal I've ever played that a company remade like 30 years later and got it better than they did the first time around. So massive props to DOD. This is not a paid commercial for DOD. They did not send me this pedal. I bought it for myself and I love it. I could talk about it all day long. Great pedal. And something that just feels great, especially when you really want to pump this up. You know, I'm working on a setup right now, a switching setup, where I can use that for kind of build-ups, you know, like and put a filter on it and do all kinds of stuff and then switch over to the hardcore kind of thumping OC2. More kind of aggressive synth sound. Wow. Crazy. I have the Woolly Mammoth back in the setup now, and it's just crazy how aggressive it is even when I'm not playing. It just wants to go. And I thought I would end with one of my favorite modulation setups. It's the Boss PN2. Again, sadly, a pedal they don't make anymore. It's tough to find, and it is not cheap. Sorry about that. But it is an incredible pedal, and it is the most aggressive tremolo pedal I think I've ever heard. I love it, especially with the synth setup. There's no tap tempo, there's no expression. You have to actually get down there and change the rate if you want to. It's a lot of fun. I highly recommend messing around with a tremolo, with the distortion, the OC2, the compressor, that basic synth bass setup. These have been a few things I've loved over the years, a few things I've come up with myself, a few things I've stolen from Jojo and John and Tim and anyone else who's probably ever played synth bass. And it's a constantly evolving situation. I have pedals on the way right now that I know are gonna enhance this situation. I know there are pedals that I don't even know about yet that I'm gonna go, wow, I can use this with that and the other thing. It's all about being curious. It's all about experimenting. These are a few of my ideas. What are your ideas? Leave me some comments. Hip me to some things that I haven't heard of yet. I want to check it out. I want to check out everything I possibly can. And if you are sitting on a gold mine of information, I want to hear it. I want to check out what your pedal setup is. I hope this has been useful for you. If you were thinking about getting into playing some synth bass, didn't really know where to start, this is the really simple, basic starting point. The signal chain, the compressor, the octave, the distortions, the modulation. That's pretty much how I do it every single time. I hope that helps. Have fun with it. These pedals, these sounds should just bring a massive evil grin to your face like they do for me when I play them. So that's it. We're done. I'll see you tomorrow.